In this video, I want to show you how to log into PayPal and get your transaction history. There's actually a lot that I want to show you, so I'll make multiple videos and I'll try to give them good descriptions so you can watch whichever one fits your needs. So first up, we got to log into PayPal. Okay, so as is the rule, when I log into my stuff, please don't judge my spending. I've logged into my PayPal. I'm doing this February 2025, so hopefully when you're watching the video, the images and so forth are still relevant for what you're experiencing. I want to find my transaction history. So what I'll do is I'll go to Activity, and then I'll go to All Transactions. And then I can see the transactions that I've had. I can download them by clicking on this. This feels kind of helpful. I can see balance affecting versus all transactions. I like the balance affecting report. So I'm going to grab the balance affecting, and then I'll just say past 3 months as a CSV. I like getting it as a CSV, even though it's not pretty, and it's really not pretty, because I'm able to get the running balance down the right-hand side. If I get it as a PDF, I don't think I'll get the running balance. So let me just grab both of these and we'll see. I'm just waiting for it to say available for download. Let's grab the CSV while the PDF is thinking. So I hit a few columns with people's names and email addresses and so forth, but this is my balance affecting report. So I can see that I had money in, a fee taken out. Here's the remaining money. This is me spending money. So my minuses are my spend, my positives are my deposits. And then over to the right, I can see my running balance. I need my running balance so that I know when this thing happens, what's my new balance. It's the only way I can make sure that I have the right transactions in QuickBooks if I'm able to reconcile my transactions against the balance. Let's see if that PDF is available. Okay, so the PDF is also available. I'm going to click on download. This is what the PDF looks like. I did redact the handful of private information, but when you're looking at this, you don't see the running balance. The problem I have with PayPal is definitely my own. It's when I'm entering stuff from PayPal, I definitely miss something or I double add something. Like it's the reason I connect it to QuickBooks rather than trying to download and upload data. I need to have something with a running balance so that I can check and see like, okay, as of the 5th, am I good? As of the 10th, do I match? Did things go off the rails on the 15th? Sometimes PayPal is one of those ones where I'm really checking every 5 or so days, not 5 or so days in real life, but 5 or so days worth of entries. Like, what's my balance in QuickBooks? What is it on my PDF for my CSV file? Like back and forth to see if I've done something wrong or wacky. This is just one way to get your history out of PayPal. I'm gonna make a handful of videos to show different ways to get history and make sure you know how to connect it to QuickBooks. So if there's something you're looking for and I don't have a video for it, just let me know. I'm more than happy to log into my PayPal and make demo videos. If you need help where you and I meet via Zoom and I walk you through how to do things, feel free to book time with me. You can get on my calendar at gentlefrog.com/meeting. If you're really frustrated, you're pulling your hair out, you just want it to get better, send me an email, let me know. I'll give you a proposal just to fix whatever's going on, and then you can resume the DIY approach. Okay, thanks. Bye.